Welcome to Audio Video System playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain baffles in loudspeaker. So in this session, to explain baffles, these are my session outlines. Where first, in this session, I am going to cover basics of baffles, necessity of baffles and structure of baffles. And then after, we will see different types of baffles in which I'll be covering infinite length of baffles, finite length of baffles, enclosures, as well as Bayes reflex baffles. And then after, I'll explain hi-fi system loudspeaker in which how baffles are connected inside. So all those things in detail, we are going to study baffles in this session. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of baffles. So basically, baffle, that we use it to extend the edges of loudspeaker cone. So when you see the structure of any loudspeaker cone, there is a need of extension of it. So that you will get to know after this session, why do we need to extend the edges. So that extension of edges, that is referred as baffle. The term baffle is commonly used for a plane surface. So a baffle increases effective length of acoustical transformation path in between front and back of radiator. So the speaker which is there with us is having cone, and we need to increase its acoustical path. And why do we need to increase its acoustical path? That I'll discuss it in necessity. So you will get to know like, why do we need to have baffle? So the basically, if you observe the structure, then you will get to know. Like see, if I say this is what a sound speaker unit which we have, and with this sound speaker unit there will be cone, so that I have shown it over here, you can see. And this extension of this cone, that is referred as baffle. Now see, when you observe this sound speaker is generating sound, you'll be finding in front direction. Front waves are happening in this direction like this. And at the same time, there will be generation of back waves. Now see this generated back waves. Again, that will come in front direction after having generated in back direction. And you'll be finding some waves, those are actually moving by this path, and it will come from back to front. Now see, this, if this baffle is not there, in that case, this sound wave will travel from back to front with smaller path length. But due to this baffle, this back sound wave that cannot travel in front direction with shorter path length. So one agenda, that is to increase path length of this back sound wave. Agenda is to increase path length of this back sound wave. Why do we need to increase it? So let us try to understand that. See, when sound is generated in front direction, at the time there are two possibilities. There can be compression or rarefaction. If sound is having compression in front direction, then in back direction there will be rarefaction. If sound is having rarefaction in back direction, in that case front direction, in that case there will be compression in back direction. So there will be opposite phenomenon which is there in front and back direction. So what happens is, like, whatever sound which is happening in back direction, that will be 180 degree out of phase compared to the sound which is there in front direction. So as if these two sound is getting combined, it will cancel their effect, as front is having compression and back is having rarefaction, or front is having rarefaction and back is having compression. So that back sound and front sound will cancel their effect. That's why we need baffle to increase that path length. And if you increase that path length, then that addition of front and back waves will get small. So you'll be finding that nullification of sound will not happen. So this is the basic agenda which is there with baffle. So see the necessity, so it will be more clear. Like, see, there is air on both of the side of cone, in front as well as back. Hence cone radiates sound in both of the sides, front as well as back. When cone moves forward, there will be compression at front and rarefaction at back. When cone moves backward, at that time there will be rarefaction in front and compression at back. Thus sound produces front and back is in opposite phase to the each other. So when sound comes from front to back, it will cancel their effect to this effect of the sound, and that will reduce its efficiency. So all we do is we use baffles in loudspeaker, which will increase its path length of sound from backside. At low frequency, wavelength is very big. So the problem of back sound is very large in low frequency loudspeaker. So in low frequency loudspeaker like woofer, we need larger baffle, while in high frequency loudspeaker like tweeter, we need smaller baffle. So baffles are used to increase path length of sound from backside. So this is the basic necessity which is there with baffles. Now when we talk about baffles, then there are basically four types of baffles which is commonly used. One is finite baffle, second is infinite baffle, third is enclosure, fourth is bars reflex baffle. We will see all four in detail one by one. So let us see first finite baffle. So in finite baffle, see, the wooden cabinet, as in radio receiver or TV receiver, act as a finite baffle. So you'll be finding in wooden cabinet, radio receiver, or in TV receiver, you'll be finding finite baffle is there. Such baffles, being of finite size, are not very effective and do cause some loss of low frequency signal due to diffraction. So you'll be finding this finite baffle system is not effective and we need some improvement. So you'll be finding infinite baffle is there. So in infinite baffle, that sound unit is having cone which is generating sound, an extension that we have it for very long baffle. So that is what infinite baffle. So practically it is impossible, like you cannot have infinity length of baffle. But here I am just indicating it, like if you have infinity length of baffle, then back sound will not come into front direction. So one thing that one can do, like if you have wall over here, like wooden wall, and in that if you make a hole, then front sound that will not get affected by back sound, as there is hole and back sound is there in other side of hole wall. So that one can say it is infinite baffle, right? But practically it is not possible. Now infinity length baffle, so that is having ideally infinite baffle, and it is one which infinity lateral dimensions are there, but it is not feasible. So however, if baffle dimensions are so large, then frequency at which path length is of lambda by 2 is far below the lowest frequency to be used, such baffle can be considered as infinity baffle. So for low frequency, you will be finding path length that is very, means wavelength is very large and path difference is lambda by 2. So if you can have such baffle which is having dimension of lambda by 2, in that case one can consider that baffle is infinite baffle. Let us consider a case. See, if I say I just want to calculate lambda by 2 for a frequency of 30 hertz. So for 30 hertz frequency, lambda is equals to c divided by f, where c, that is velocity of sound, that is 340, divided by frequency, that is 30. So 340 divided by 30. So you will be finding lambda value, that is 340 divided by 30, means it will be 11 point something. So lambda by 2, that will be 5.5 meter, somewhat like that. So that dimension is even very large. So in case of length of 5.5 meter for frequency 30 hertz, one can say that is infinite length of baffle. So that is even not good idea, but one can consider that definition. For example, speaker is fixed in a hole in a wall of house. As the dimension of wall are quite large, wall act as a natural barrier and rare sound will not come in front. So we can consider that baffle as infinity length of baffle. And one more way is there. Practically infinity baffle is not possible as it is having very huge dimensions. Several designs are developed to reduce the size, and one such design that one can see, I am just showing it step by step. Like, see, this is sound unit, then there is cone, and now you see this shape of baffle is there. So now it does not, this back sound, that does not need to go like this. Now it will get diverted in this direction because of this shape. So this is one shape which can provide length of infinite length of baffle. And next one is enclosure. So now you see in enclosure, all we do is we have sound unit loudspeaker, and here one can see cone, and now complete sound unit loudspeaker that is getting enclosed in enclosure. So this is what enclosure, where we don't allow back sound to go in front direction. We just keep that rare sound in enclosure. So we keep rare sound in enclosure to not allow that rare sound to get effect, to give its effect in front direction. So that's why we keep it in enclosure. So this is what about enclosure. Now when we talk about enclosure, then the enclosure that should be kept in closed box, and opening is there in front direction where we keep our speaker. The purpose is to serve infinite baffle, because the wave from back direction will not come in front direction. So such enclosed box is called as enclosure. You can see that, like, this is a cone, and we don't want that back signal to come in front direction. So we keep it in enclosure. And that purpose is to serve as a infinity baffle. Now see, the best material used for enclosure is about 18 mm thick plywood or practical board, and solid timber is not good because of timber grain can produce resonance at some frequency. So we don't use timber. The reason is it produces some resonance. So we can use that plywood of 18 mm thick plywood within that useful audio frequency range. It will be having resonance with timber, so we don't use it. The box must be airtight, and all joints should be glued, and all terminals or wire on the back panel should be sealed. So that wire even we need to seal. Why? The reason is wavelength is very large. So if wavelength is large, then small space even will make way of sound to come out of it. So we need to seal wire so accurately, and that box should be airtight so that back sound will not come in front direction. So this is what we need to focus about when we make enclosure. Now see, next is bass reflex enclosure. So you'll be finding radiation from back direction. That is what, if we use it to strengthen front radiation, then that will be bass reflex enclosure. So the port is designed in such a way so that rear sound will come in front direction with the phase difference of 180 degree. Already 180 degree phase difference is there, so additional 180 degree phase will make it to 360 degree phase, so it will not decrease effect of front sound. So if you make a way in front direction such a way where 180 degree phase shift is happening from back to front, in that case that problem could be solved, as back sound is already 180 degree out of phase, so an additional 180 degree will result into phase difference of 360 means 0 degree, so we can increase sound strength compared to the sound strength which is there in front direction. So this is what the basic agenda which is there with bass reflex. So one can see this is what speaker, where if you have sound in this direction and if you add additional 180 degree phase, in that case the direction that will be completely reversed. So algebraic addition will happen. Like, see, right now if I say sound is happening in this direction, means let us say it is compression. So for compression here there will be rear fraction, and if you provide lambda by 2 path length in this direction, then when it comes over here, then that compression will get converted into rear fraction as 180 degree phase is there. So both of this signal will get added over here, and you will be finding that reflection of bus that will increase, that will strengthen front radiation of sound. So this is what the basic agenda which is there with bus reflex enclosures. Now see the acoustic labyrinth. So that is quite interesting. You will be getting how we are doing this. See, for low frequency speaker, bass reflex enclosure will have large dimensions. So this is one limitation, as lambda by 2, that is very large. So for low frequency speaker, bass reflex enclosure is even not a good idea. So to reduce dimensions, all we can do is we can divide enclosure in parts so that we can reduce dimensions. Now see that reduction in dimension, that we can have it by having partition, and that is to provide additional path difference of 180 degree. So let us try to understand how that is been done. Like, see, this is sound unit. Over here there is cone, and now we have enclosure like this. Now this dimension can be reduced as if you provide partitions like this. Now see, here there is port to way out. So when you turn on this sound system, sound will go in front direction, as you can see. In back direction even sound will be there, but it will go like this. You can see the path, and then it will come out. So by having partition, we can have this length which is lambda by 2 with smaller dimensions. Right, so by having partitions in enclosure, we can reduce the dimensions, and this is what the basic agenda which is there with this acoustic labyrinth. Now see the hi-fi enclosure, so it will be more clear. Now see, single loudspeaker cannot have flat frequency response over 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So we need multiple speaker for that type of response, which is a basic requirement of hi-fi system, where in hi-fi system you'll be finding frequency response is there from 40 hertz to 15 kilohertz. So in hi-fi system, see, there will be multiple speaker. So here this sound unit that is there for tweeter, this sound unit that is there for woofer. Now we have this cone over here, one can see it. We just keep it in enclosure. So this is what I have kept it in enclosure. Now you see this tweeter, that is of high frequency. So for high frequency in back direction you don't need any partitions, but for woofer it is of low frequency, so for that we need partitions. So here I have provided partitions, you can see it. And now in back, front sound will be having back sound, and in back sound for high frequency we don't need partition as I have told, and that could be utilized in this enclosure. But for woofer it is of low frequency, so for that I have provided partitions. So this wave that will go like this, one can see, and then it will come out from here. So resultant of these two speaker, that will be having very good frequency response, and that one can utilize in hi-fi enclosure by using multiple speaker. So addition of woofer, tweeter, mid-range and speaker could be utilized by having this type of partitioning of enclosure. So this is what about hi-fi enclosure. I hope that you have understood this. Why do we use baffles? Why do we use enclosure? And how we can use those things? So I think you can understand all those things after watching this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in the university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel. Thank you so much.